Hi there. My name is Sevag Demirjian. This presentation is part of an educational series about kidney medicine and extracorporeal support. Enjoy.
Catheter port nomenclature can be confusing sometimes, especially if you consider other extracorporeal support systems, such as ECMO. So let's agree on some basic terminology. A typical naming scheme in dialysis is arterial and venous ports, which makes sense with arteriovenous fistula or graft access, but not so much with catheter access, where both drainage and transfusions are from a vein. I prefer access or drain line nomenclature for blood leaving the patient and return for blood returning to patient. The basic layout for dialysis will include a blood pump, and in the case of a diffusion-based modality, will include a dialysate pump and an influent pump. Dialysis circuits will have pressure sensors to monitor circuit hemodynamics. On the blood line, pressures are negative before the blood pump and positive after. The first pressure pod on the blood line is the access or drain line pressure pod. The baseline pressure here is a function of catheter characteristics and prescribed blood flow rate. Typically is less than 100 in CRRT setups. Next is the filter pressure sensor between the blood pump and the filter. Its baseline pressure is dictated by the blood flow rate, the filter size, and blood viscosity, and if anything is obstructed downstream. Return pressure, like the access pressure, is determined by blood flow rate and catheter characteristics. Effluent pressure sensor, which sits between the membrane and dialysate flowing out, is a function of UF rate prescribed and membrane flux characteristics. Access pressure gets increasingly negative. The reason is due to the pump pulling harder to maintain a constant flow, which could be due to catheter clotting or kink in the line. Access pressure can be positive when the dialysis line is hooked up to an ECMO circuit right after the ECMO pump. The filter pressure will rise due to filter clotting or any blockade or kink in the line downstream. Similarly, the return pressure can go up when the catheter port is clotted or the return line is blocked or kinked. If the return pressure drops, however, that's concerning for disconnected catheter. You can use the filter and return pressures to calculate filter pressure drop, which represents the average pressure on the blood side of the membrane. Subtract the effluent pressure from the dialysate side from the pressure drop. Then you'll have the transmembrane pressure. Transmembrane pressure is helpful because it trends upwards with filter clotting or membrane fouling, or in other words, clogging. More on this later. Transmembrane pressure can drop due to membrane leak or pre-filter infusion due to lowering in blood viscosity. Effluent pressure can be positive or negative. It is usually positive with a new membrane, which are typically high flux, meaning that they have high ultrafiltration coefficient, which in turn means that plasma water passes through easily. And since the effluent pump will only allow the pre-specified volume to go through, the sensor will usually have positive pressure. On the other hand, with filter clotting or clogging, the pump will start pulling to maintain the rate and it becomes negative. Most machines will also have blood leak sensors, which sometimes can be triggered due to effluent fluid discoloration, for example, due to high bilirubin levels. Next, let's take a look at circuit hemodynamics with clotting and clogging. Within the filter, as plasma water is pushed out hollow fiber membrane pores, especially with high rates of convection, plasma proteins build against the membrane and form a protein cake layer, effectively fouling the membrane or clogging. You'll also observe a gradual rise in transmembrane pressure, TMP, as the same amount of plasma water is pulled across the smaller surface area. Filter clotting can start as microclotting within the hollow fibers. Effectively, a small clot will neutralize a whole fiber. This will lead to gradual rise in filter pressure and also transmembrane pressure. We'll use the Prisma CRT machines to point out the pressure pods that we have discussed. There's the access pressure, filter pressure between the pump and the filter, return pressure, and the effluent pressure pods. The location of these pressure pods are the same on the newer Prismax machine. Hope you enjoyed the presentation.